Now, we want to show you this incredible video of two hormone-charged males fighting, possibly over a woman, but it's not from a pub in Dublin. As you can see, it is two red-bellied black snakes fighting, and this can last for up to 30 minutes.
Yeah, wildlife advocate Ben Dessen says this is one of the most amazing videos he's seen. Ben's here with us. Good morning,
hey,
Ben.
Hey, Ben.
Morning, guys.
This is terrifying for me, but these snakes are fighting. What is it that you love most about seeing these? Are they really fighting over a woman?
They certainly are, yeah. So you can imagine me being the snake nutter that I am, walking through the park with my Labrador, turn a corner, bam, there's two male snakes engaging in male-to-male combat. This behaviour is often mistaken for mating, but it is actually two boys, and what they do is they fight. Think of it as kind of like a thumb war or a big arm wrestle amongst a couple of blokes at the pub. And what they're trying to do is they're trying to pin each other down, with the more dominant male being the stronger one, holding the submissive male down until eventually one of them gives up, takes off, and the winner gets to mate with all the ladies that come into his territory.
Hang on a second. So you were just walking through the park, what, in suburban Sydney, and you saw this happen?
That's right, exactly. So this is an incredibly rare behaviour to find. So, you know, for a snake lover like myself to come across it, you can imagine I'm on all fours, camera out, there's people around, there was a guy flying a drone overhead filming it. It was the most amazing thing to witness. And it can last anywhere from sort of 5 to 10 minutes, even into the hours, if there's sort of two equally challenged males, both a similar size. It just goes and goes and goes
until
one of them gives up. One of the guys won, and the other guy took off, tail between his legs.
Where's the girl?
She's waiting for him, so absolutely incredible. And the other cool thing about red-bellied blacks is the females, they actually have what's called like kind of like a prenatal group, where all of the females get together before they give birth, 5 or 6 of them at a time, and they just hang out until they give birth.
Wow.
So most snakes are solitary, but red-belly males combat, females hang out, and then the babies are born.
It's always incredible. A dangerous day when you bring a big plastic tub, like the one next to the seat that you're
hanging
sitting
out down
on there.
Here, for sure.
What's in the tub, Ben?
Do you want to see?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
It's moving.
So last time I was on, I had the smaller snake, so I thought we'd warm you guys up with that.
The small snake.
The small one.
The small snake.
Today...
Who are they fighting over today, Sarah?
Today, I've brought in something just a little bit bigger. So this is Oliver, Oliver is an olive python. So these are the second longest species of snake that we have here in Australia.
Wow.
It's absolutely gorgeous.
Oliver.
Oliver the olive python, very original name.
Tell us about Oliver.
So Oliver actually came from a suburban Sydney home in West Ryde. We got a call late at night from someone saying, I've got this giant snake in my living room, come and get it. So one of my close friends headed out, picked him up. And sure enough, he was an olive python, and these guys aren't from Sydney. They're from the Northern Territory, North Queensland, so he was quite far from home.
So what do you reckon, he hitched a ride on a truck or something?
Possibly. Often escape pets get out. You know, people keep these guys as pets, and he could have got out
and
turned up in
seats?
This person's house.
I don't know.
You all right?
I don't feel very comfortable in my stomach, but I'm trying to figure out why. I'm trying to face this fear now.
What if we touch? Are we able to touch him?
Yeah, we can start small. So I'll keep the head end. Look, often people are scared of the head end, but this is the end you have to look out for.
Oh, why?
Why are you putting that to us then? Start with the head end.
I've seen plenty of snake diarrhea in my time, and it's not very pleasant.
Oh, that's all right. So
it actually feel beautiful. Yeah.
We're coming into winter. There's been lots of rain around as well.
That's right.
Especially in the eastern states. Does that mean more snakes are about? Are they looking for higher, drier land?
Yeah.
Are they coming into homes?
Definitely. Look, throughout the flooding that we've had, that has displaced a lot of snakes. But what we'll find is coming into winter now, they're probably going to go into a little burrow and go into what's called brumation or hibernation for winter. So springtime is typically when you're going to see them. That's when I filmed that video where the two males were combating. But towards the end of winter is when that mating and sort of that sort of behaviour occurs generally.
If you're bitten by a red-bellied black snake, would you die?
Look, if you didn't get treatment, you didn't get to hospital, definitely. They're highly venomous snakes, but red bellies are actually incredibly shy, secretive animals. They're one of my favourite species. So provided you sort of keep your distance, you never get too close, they're fine. They're never going to try to attack you.
We saw a red-bellied black snake swimming in the shallows of the beach.
Did
it had fallen out of a tree, and we thought it was a seat snake until we saw the flash of the red belly.
Yeah.
Getting all the kids out of the water.
Beautiful snakes. As long as you keep your distance, and if they are in an area where there are kids or pets around, call your local snake catcher and they're going to come and move them on safely.
You're very quiet, Tristan.
I know. It's a very common phobia that people have, though, isn't it?
Like, that's correct.
Because every time you come here, you go, just relax, and it's the last thing I can do. And then I can feel it tightening up on me, and so I don't know how to relax in that situation.
It's that fear of the unknown, and what I find is a lot of people, once they have got up close to a snake and they've touched it, they go, oh, that's not so bad. They've got this preconceived idea of that they're these, you know, terrifying animals out to get you, and that's my mission in life, and I know Craigie Bennett's as well. We always love trying to share that share that passion for these incredible animals. And you don't have to love them, but at least appreciate them and respect them.
Do you know what? I definitely appreciate them and respect them. I just don't know what to do when they eyeball you. Or it looks like they're eyeballing you. Like, I want to play a part here. I want to be nice to them, but I don't know if you can like me or not.
Yeah, no, he's fine. You can see how relaxed he is. And then the main thing is you being calm, because I find a lot of the time when someone's nervous and you give them a snake and they're shaking, snake gets on edge as well. But if you're calm and relaxed, snake's going to be very calm. It's like any animal, really.
Hey, man.
Oh, wow. Look, during a bit of a crowd, people are coming to see you with your big snake. A snake in a TV studio.
Getting a snake out on telly, you know?
Thank you, Ben, for bringing your slimy little slithery
friends.
Not slimy.
Not slimy.
They're not slimy. They're scaly friends. And your passion for this is wonderful. I actually took my kids into Kellyville Pets.
Oh, awesome.
And it's like a pet Disneyland there,
that's
isn't
right.
it? Yeah.
Yeah. And we love sharing that passion, so maybe they'll work on you and get a pet snake.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
I'm very aware that I smell of tomahawk steak.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, we've just eaten meat. Would he smell that on us?
Yeah, oh, not really. I mean, steak's not a normal part of their diet. I can tell you my stomach was rumbling.
Bit of Bernays sauce.
Cooking.
I thought
amazing.
It was the meat, though, whether they'd smell the meat.
Yeah.
No, okay.
Yeah,
nah. No.
No, they like fur.
He's looking at you.
Oh, well, then I'm fine, then.
Yeah.
Get Judy's bottom out.
Go to bendessen.com.au to see more of Ben's work. Ben, thanks for coming on.
Thanks,
always
guys.
Great to
thanks,
see
always
you.
A pleasure.
Bye, Oliver.
Thank you.
Awesome. See you, Ollie.